your way from the rent.
Oh, okay, all right. Hi, everybody. Good afternoon, and welcome to homecoming and our chorale reunion. We are very excited to take ourselves back to the wonderful days that we spent with Mr. Beach, and very, very pleased to have Mrs. Beach here as well. I'm Carl Rosenberger, the president of the Campus Alumni Society, and we are also very, very happy to have everyone here. Just want to make a couple of comments about the Alumni Society. One of the things that we do is raise money for scholarships, and we are very proud to say that we have raised $17,000 in the past 3 years for scholarships here on campus. There is some information about the society and our events in your packets that you were given, including our upcoming Thon Bingo on December 10th. It's a great time. We're also selling gift card calendars, only $5, and right back there. And it's a quick little $5 buy, and you can get $25, $50, $100 gift cards. Good time of the year for those things. So we'll say a little bit more, and Courtney is going to come up and say a few words before we start, but thank you for being here. I hope we don't embarrass ourselves.
No danger.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to campus. I am Courtney Glass. I am the new director of development here on campus, so I am excited to meet everyone, and I've been very warmly welcomed so far to campus, so thank you very much. I'm also so happy to see so many of you here to honor Professor and Mrs. Beach and their impact on our community. While I've only been in this role for a little over 6 months, I'm constantly humbled at the passion and dedication our alumni and community shows to our campus. So thank you for all that you do to share in the mission. So I just wanted to say, as many of you have heard, Penn State is starting a new fundraising campaign, because we're always in a fundraising campaign. But this one is called A Greater Penn State for 21st Century Excellence. And the overall university goal is $1.6 billion. It's the second largest campaign ever undertaken by Penn State. The first largest was the last one. So here at Penn State Schuylkill, we have committed to raise $5 million by the end of the campaign, which is a significant goal, but I know that we will get there thanks to everybody's support. One of the key areas for support has been the Open Doors Initiative. So it's our goal here at Penn State Schuylkill and everywhere at Penn State to ensure that students from every background have access to a Penn State education and that they graduate on time and on track to success. And I was reading a little bit, but when the James W. and Edna M. Beach Renaissance Scholarship was established back in 2006, little did anyone know how much this scholarship would actually fit right in with the imperatives of this campaign. I'm happy to say that over the years, the scholarship has grown to over $50,000 in value. Wow. It has supported 10 students over the years, and the total amount of support that has gone to those students has been $21,000. So it averages about $1,000 to $2,000 per student. So I just want everyone to give yourself a round of applause for that, because that is amazing. And while I never had the opportunity to know Professor Beach, I believe I can safely say that his memory is wonderfully preserved for generations to come, thanks to all of you and his family and friends. So in light of this special reunion today here on campus, many of your classmates who have not been able to join us have decided to show their support by making an additional gift to the scholarship. If you would like to join them, there is a pledge card included in your folders, and I'm happy to answer any questions that you might have. Whether you're able to make a contribution or not, your presence here today and your preservation of Professor Beach's legacy is the true testament of his impact on the campus. So thank you so much. Thank you very much. I will be here to answer any questions, and it was wonderful to meet all of you.
Can I just interrupt?
Oh. Certainly.
I'd just like to... Thank you. Also say thank you so much for these wonderful kids, that I still call them kids. And so, I don't know how many we have actually in of alums of the chorale, have no idea how many. It's quite a few hundred. But they are our family. Jim and I were not blessed with children of our own, but we had all these umpteen ones. And some of them, we were glad we could send them home at night. But we still love them so much, and well, thank you so much. All you people who say such nice things, almost every day somebody says something about Jim, and it keeps him alive for me. Music was his life, and you kids were his life. So thank you all for coming. We love you too.
Choir, I'd like to introduce it. The members here were from all different classes, but we all look so young. None of us have changed. I'm Kathy Stone Zimmerman. I was here 72 to 74. And without further ado, we've been practicing for months. So we hope you like it. We'd like to open with something that Mr. Beebe used quite a bit when he went out to sing at different venues.
Actually, of two songs, The Shadow of Your Smile and More.
Thank you. Thank you.
class are Mr. Beach's without the Penn State fight songs. So we are going to do the Nittany Lion and Fight on State, leading also into the alma mater. And we will welcome you to join along with us. I just have to tell a really quick story. I hope you don't mind me sharing this, but I spent 2 years at Schuylkill campus, and then I took a year off to work and kind of get my mind where I wanted to be at, and I was trying to decide if I wanted to stay at Penn State as a music education major or go to another school that at the time was a little more well-known for music education, but Penn State has a great music education program, and I found that out even more after I got up there. But when I went up to the main campus, I was honored to be selected to march with the Marching Blue Band. And one of the traditions of the Blue Band is, as a rookie, you must sing the Nittany Lion, or you have to run laps after every practice. Do they still do that, guys?
Yeah.
Okay. And I thought I was good because I knew them all because Mr. Beach had taught them to us. Unfortunately, the rest of the rookies did not know the words. So I still had to run the laps. Darn. But then there was one rehearsal where, at the time I was there, Ned C. Deal was the director, and he knew I was a music ed major, although I was a vocal major, not an instrumental major. But I had background in instrumental, and he pointed to me at the end of one practice. He said, "Judy, you get up here and you lead this." And I thought, oh, this is great. Because he thought, you know, let me just pick a rookie out and see if they know it. And there were two other chorale members in the band at the time. Jay Yankovosky was one. And I can't think of who the other was, but I was going to call the two of them up and do it in harmony and really throw them off. But then he said, "No, I'm just kidding," and he sent me back down. And I still had to run laps, but I always felt grateful because I already knew the words to the song and to the alma mater because that was part of our tradition. So please feel free to join with us as we sing the fight songs. If you know. Right on stage. rise while we sing the alma mater of Penn State.
L-U-T-K-I-N, which is the name of the composer of the piece. It's one of our favorites. We just love to sing it. And I think, should we try this a cappella?
Sure.
So we're going to try it a cappella, and we hope you enjoy it. It means a lot to the Beaches, to all of us, and we hope it does to you. Thank you again for coming.
Give you peace.
Thank you once again to everyone for sharing this time with us. I know I got a blast out of it, and I think